Auroras are spectacular. These dancing lights visit the polar skies when charged particles strike the Earth's upper atmosphere, causing the atoms and molecules there to glow in a variety of colors. Now there's a new dancer in town, a thin purple arc named Steve. The phenomenon was first spotted by citizen scientists observing the aurora. In addition to its unusual color, Steve also stood out based on its location. It appeared closer to the equator than other auroras, which are typically spotted at latitudes between 65 and 80 degrees. The regions of the atmosphere where these light shows normally occur form a large oval over each magnetic pole of the Earth. During times of increased solar activity, these ovals broaden, moving toward the equator. This feature, dubbed Steve by citizen photographers who were surprised but it just kept showing up in the skies over southern Canada, was a narrow purple line in the night sky. Citizen photographers have captured hundreds of images of Steve over the last few years, usually during times of increased auroral activity. In July 2016, the European Space Agency's Swarm A satellite flew over Steve, revealing that a previously known phenomenon called subauroral ion drift, or SAID, may explain its unusual properties. SAIDs are narrow regions of charged particles moving rapidly to the west, sometimes at speeds exceeding 5 kilometers per second. Researchers believe that Steve is simply an optical manifestation of an SAID, a phenomenon that's been measured before but never seen. Thanks to satellite data and observations from citizen scientists, researchers now have a better understanding of this atmospheric feature. In a nod to the original informal name, scientists have suggested that it be called a strong thermal emission velocity enhancement, otherwise known as Steve. The discovery of Steve helps highlight the importance of citizen science and the many ways in which professional scientists and enthusiastic amateurs can work together.